second burial ground. It is so good to see you here on this beautiful day. A few days ago, Jabril and I came out here to kind of scope the area out to see where we were going to set things up. And we looked at the forecast and it said 80% rain for today. But he and I made a declaration that day. And we said we wanted it to be a day just like today. So, Ashe. Ashe. This, my friends, is a sacred place and a sacred space. So I want you just to take a moment now. Take a deep breath. Take a deep breath in. And take a deep breath out. And just take that in. Committed to loosening the grip of hate and divisiveness by embracing our common humanity and moving us towards a greater understanding and acceptance of our differences by fostering genuine and meaningful connections across diverse groups of people, like yourself, like we're here today. So we have a core group that meets regularly. And I'm going to acknowledge a couple of those folks that are here today. Jabril, Malik Hassan is one that will be speaking. Annette Khan, sitting over here, is also one. Jessica Coffey is one. Thank you so much for being here. And then we've got other top fans of our Facebook page that are here also. So thank you for being here and supporting We Stand and Divide. So I wanted to let you know that we have a website now that's still in development, but it is operational. www.westandundivided.com. You can find out more information about what it is we do. You can also add your email if you want to subscribe to getting information about our upcoming events. And we have on this table business cards if you want to spread and take one with you as you leave today. So we are excited. We're excited to be here today with you. And in the spirit, we're here in the spirit with our ancestors. And to get us started off, we are going to have Greg Abdussalam, who is the administrator of the local Muslim American Community, RVA, lead us in a grounding prayer.
Hallowed sacred grounds, we invoke the name of the One who has never been absent from any place or time. You are far beyond and cannot be constrained by space or time. Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim, the most gracious benefactor, the merciful Redeemer. The originator of galaxies, stars, systems of planets, every living species known and unknown. We evoke your presence here, in this space, in meditative reflection and silence. As we give and pay homage and remembrance of the many souls that have preceded us, now dust to the ages, but whose seed indeed, the very DNA in every soul of our being, your essence will remain encoded till the end of time. Through the door of no return, they were stolen into captivity, up the James to these Manchester docks. Too many lost, forgotten to the ocean's depths of the Atlantic. But Maya said, by your permission, still we rise. Even today, the struggle for dignity continues. Vital lives, full of potential, yet to be realized. Lives still usher forth, and lives still robbed of fulfillment. Men and women, the souls that you created, we ask, what right do they have? African ancestors, stolen from their native land, we ask, what right do they have? Our men, women, and yes, children, lives cut short, we ask, what right do they have? By the end of a whip or that of a noose, we ask, what right do they have? Spirit and bone, crushed, erased from this life's sojourn, we ask, what right do they have? Taken from us, George Floyd, Breonna Taylor, Michael Brown, Trayvon Martin, Martin, Malcolm, Medgar, say their names, gone too soon, we ask, what right do they have? We evoke you, the omnipresent, the omnipotent, we stand ready for your service. The imprint of your divine will resides in the subtle breeze, in the implosion of stars, and the vicissitudes of humanity to aid you. Nothing can escape. Like grains of sand or dust, we are both insignificant and significant. By your permission alone, we submit. By your permission alone, the eyes and the heart awaken to remembrance, duty, and love of our people. Only by your permission, we commemorate African souls set free, Juneteenth, a proclamation yet to be fulfilled. Too many souls gone by, but never to be forgotten. By your permission, we still stand. May we be worthy. We await your divine command for a just society made due. A society where your dominion seeks the family of man in their rightful places. We invoke your holy name, the omnipresent, the omnipotent.
Thank you so much, Brother Grant. That was beautiful. So before I introduce anyone else, I want to share what we do at We Stand Up Divided. We come together to educate ourselves about each other, to provide service within the community, and to make group and individual contributions to impact lives by being active participants and encouraging positive change. That's why, my friends, we are here. Each month we meet and we highlight an organization that we want to make a donation or contribution to. So we normally make a donation and then we also participate in some kind of volunteer service. This month we are highlighting Alegba Folklore Society. Amen, yes. Alegba Folklore Society, they had a Juneteenth program a few days ago. I don't know if any of you saw that online, but it was awesome, an awesome program. And what they normally do is they have their program down at the docks, and after, or right at dusk, they take people on the enslaved walk. They took the people on the trail of the enslaved people, the walk, which is about a 2-mile walk. And then they eventually end up right here, right where you are today. And then they have a ceremony recognizing and honoring the ancestors. So you are part of this big grand history. So I wanted to share a little bit about Allegra Folklore Society, and instead of me talking about it, I am going to let Janine Bell, who is the artistic director, she's not here. She might be here though. She might be coming. She's not here, but we're going to play a little clip so you can understand more about what Allegra is all about. Mission is to provide educational opportunities through the arts. We want to present high quality arts engagement, but also the opportunity inside for transformation. We also get out into the community as well. Our performing company of African dancers, drummers, singers, masquerade, spoken word artists present from a wide repertoire around the city, outside of the city, outside of the state. On the other side of that, though, more seriously, we guide cultural history tours along the trail of enslaved Africans and other notable sites. And so people are able to walk in our ancestors' footsteps to hear their words, their stories. When you can know where you are, it helps you to know who you are. It helps you to have ownership in the history that you, they, we are making each day. So we hope that me personally and at the Allegra Folklore Society that we're doing something to make a difference there. Allegra, the word comes from the Yoruba cosmology. The Yoruba people are in parts of Nigeria, Benin, and Togo in West Africa. They have a spiritual path called Ifa. And inside Ifa, there are Orisha, or intercessors, or aspects of nature who help God help us. And Allegra is the one who opens the roads to bring clarity out of confusion. So you can also donate online at Allegra Folklore Society's website. I think it's EFSINC.org. Or you can just give it to this lady right here. Okay. It is our pleasure. It is our pleasure. Did you want to say anything, Janine? Since you're here.
This is the time and we're the people. You know, some folks came by our cultural center earlier today. They may come down here. I don't know if they will. But they were talking about the fact that while they appreciate, as do I'm sure all of us, the attention that's been given to history that has commanded our reaction from the people who are saying, oh, really? To the people who are saying, about daggum time. And they thought, as is being embodied today, that we should spend some time being proactive and give our energy to places of sacred memory, places of ancestral memory, places where the vibration can happen in a quiet way, because spirit is so quiet, is loud. So I'm grateful that all of you are here today. Thank you, thank you, thank you for those who choose to donate, because it ain't easy. The demon ain't going down without a fight. And we've been boxing for 30 years. He keep bouncing back up. I don't understand. So if you want to support, that's helpful. If you want to get to know Queen Valerie back here, or the works of the Alegba Folklore Society and how things can be ongoing, because it can't be a flash in the pan. If it's a flash in the pan, then everybody's lying right now. Just saying.
Tell it.
The revolution is being televised. And it's not ended when the commercial comes on. So, for those of you who are allies, open your spirit, open your inner ear, open your third eye to receive our truth. And what did Maya Angelou say? If somebody tells you who they are, believe them. Something like that. And for those of us, and all of us really, just talking about you. See? I just told them what you said about the reaction is powerful, but the proaction maybe even more so. I just told them. See? So it's a long walk. For us, it's been an uphill walk all of those years. So eat your Wheaties, stretch out in the morning, drink water, and don't get tired. It's not going to come easy, but it can come. The pendulum is swinging. You see that. Don't let it be a flash in the pan.
Thank you, Mama. Gotcha. It's a pleasure to meet you guys. My name is Adam Jefferson, artist and recently a stated activist, but we're working on a few things in the city the other day we were doing a bit of documentation and noticing that there was a lot of litter here. We're protesting at statues that have no right to our real history. That this is our history, this is our root, this is supposed to be a place of meditation and reflection, but how can we meditate with all of this? We need more, and our ancestors deserve more. We just left the Hollywood Cemetery not even 5 minutes ago. It's a shame that such a beautiful part of the city holds such deep and angry energy. But that here there is peace, there is love, and that if that's going to be beautiful, that this deserves to be beautiful as well. So it's up to us to make this place a proper place of reflection and meditation. Thank you, everyone. We'll get some mic next.
That was lovely. Thank you so much. Thank both of you so much. So I'm going to go ahead and introduce the rest of the folks that are going to be participating in this program tonight. One of our past, she's on our video and we stand undivided. Twang. See you later, Twang. Thanks for coming. So I want to introduce a few people that are going to be part of the program tonight. The first are our beautiful, lovely, talented drummers. Adalio Garlaza, Professor Roderick Davis, and Jonathan Hobson. Thank you for being here and gracing us with the rhythms of the drums, for it is the drums that call all things into creation. But engaging with you later on this evening. Let me introduce this beautiful spirit and personification of all things positive, Yemaja Jubilee. She'll be sharing something special with us later on. Yemaja is a lover of every moment of life and practices and embodies the belief that each day is a great day to be alive. Yemaja is a life coach, author, poet, creative consultant, songwriter, and spreads her message of love and inclusivity. Her motto is inspire, encourage, and influence. To do that for others is to always live their lives in full expression as they continue to emerge and evolve. She is co-founding director of Cultural Libations. She has co-written, produced, and directed many, many stage productions. Yemaja co-produced the movie Black Wall Street, The Money, The Music, and The People with RLP Productions, in addition to co-writing the theme song for the movie. She produces and hosts her own TV show, Love, Light, and Positivity. She also serves as creative consultant for several other shows on Comcast TV and with an internet radio station called Studio W The Buzz based in San Bernardino, California, which myself and Jabril had the honor and privilege of being on just a week ago. She is known for her postings of her daily morning walks in nature and that get her to stay in touch, in tune, and in spirit. Along with her partner, Roy Boyd, who is with her tonight, They continue to travel the world to enhance and enrich her overall view of humanity in its many variations and expressions of culture. I could go on and on and on about this beautiful lady, but we would take the whole program to do it. So thank you so much, Yamandra, for being here. Bless you. Next is our very own We Stand Undivided ambassador and facilitator for this evening's program, Mr. Jibril Malik Hassan. Take a look, my friends, at this gifted, spirit-filled young man. He is the vision of our future, standing right before us. Jibril is an active faith leader in Richmond. As a second-year student at Union Presbyterian Seminary, he is studying to provide a faith-based foundation to the timely work of social engagement and evolution. As a contemplative, he lived for 2 years at Richmond Hill, an ecumenical religious community and retreat center in the city's East End. Jibril is a graduate of Marymount University, as well as St. Christopher's School. He's also had the privilege to serve with the Peace Corps in Ethiopia. Jibril is excited to be a witness to the holistic, spiritual transformation of the planet. I am honored and privileged to have him be a part of We Stand Undivided. And knowing him gives me, and should give you too, hope for the future. Jibril Malik Hassan.
Welcome to the African Burial Ground here in Richmond. I want to just take a moment to just be silent. Just be silent. We gather here today to honor Juneteenth. And we gather in this sacred space that has been so abused through history. And that abuse is like the abuse that was endured through slavery, which facilitated the need for a Juneteenth. Can you all hear me? I'll be a little bit louder. The abuse of this land is like a symbol for the abuse that was endured through enslavement that facilitated the need for a holiday, for a celebration like Juneteenth. What is Juneteenth? Juneteenth most generally commemorates the freedom of enslaved Africans in the United States. And its primary day of celebration is June 19th. It came into being on June 19, 1865, and it was when General Granger of the Union Army came to Galveston, Texas, and he mandated that the Confederacy there release the people who were enslaved, the enslaved Africans. They had held on for 2.5 years because we know the Emancipation Proclamation was signed into effect on January 1st, 1863. But the Confederacy there held on for 2.5 years, and it's questionable why, but
One reason is that they questioned the authority of President Lincoln in former Confederate territory. And so it was mandated on June 19, 1865, that the enslaved people there be liberated. I think of my own family, who is from, my paternal grandfather was from Texas. He was from Anahuac County, Texas, very close to Beaumont. And I do wonder if maybe his family benefited from that Juneteenth celebration. In some way we all benefit, but I do wonder if he and his family benefited most directly from that Juneteenth celebration. And so the enslaved Africans celebrated their liberation in many different ways through many different festivities. At the turn of the century, particularly moving towards the Great Depression, Juneteenth celebrations died down. And then they were reignited in the time of the Black Pride Movement, when people were coming back to honor deeply the heritage of people of African descent. And so they were reignited in the 1960s. And then finally in the 1980s, it became a state holiday for Texans. And now we continue Juneteenth celebrations annually. Celebrations like this, celebrations like that of the Alegba Folklore Society, which was just conducted last weekend. I'll press it now.
Testing? All right. Great. We're going now. And so I'll say a little bit about the land on which we stand. This is the African Burial Ground. It is the first municipal cemetery for Black people here in Richmond. It was active from 1750 to 1816. And many things have invaded this land. Most recently, a parking lot by VCU. This land was paved over. And then 95 was built straight through it. I believe 1958. And 95, of course, went through Jackson Ward, which was our own Black Wall Street. And so that was the respect that was given to our ancestors. The lack of respect, rather. A creek, Shaco Creek, ran through here. And so it was a swampy piece of land. It's not the best piece of land to have a cemetery at all. And of course we know that Shaco Bottom would flood. I'm going to read some of what the Reverend Ben Campbell accounted in his book, Richmond's Unhealed History, so that you have more of a primary account experience of what this land was, what it is, and what it represents. Some of you may know that this is where General Gabriel, also known as Gabriel Prosser, was executed. We don't know where he's buried, but he was executed here. Gabriel was placed on a cart and driven to the foot of a steep hill near the corner of 15th and Broad Streets in Shaco Valley to to Richmond's burial ground for Negroes. There in the center of the sacred ground of the Africans of Richmond, he was hanged on the city gallows. The burial ground itself was in disrepair from floods and extensive use. According to Christopher McPherson, a free black clerk in Richmond, the cemetery lay directly east of the Baptist Meeting House, which is now First African Baptist, up on that hill, used to be First African Baptist. Unenclosed, very much confined as to space, under a steep hill on the margin of Shaco Creek, where every heavy rain commits ravages upon one grave or another. And some coffins have already been washed away into the current of Shaco Stream. This is a primary source account. And in a very few years, the major part of them will no doubt be washed down into the current of the James River. Added to this, many graves are on private property adjoining, liable to be taken up and thrown away whenever the ground is wanted by its owners. And furthermore, we may add the humiliating circumstance that this is the very express gallows ground where malefactors are interred. I ruminated on this ghastly scene, and now thought I, were I in a barbarous land, and such a sight like this was to present itself to my view, I should exclaim to myself, these are a poor, ignorant people. This is the land on which we stand. This is the moment that we honor. We come here to breathe. We come here to sigh. We come here to hum, to moan, to chant, to listen, to learn. We come here because we must be here at this time. We must listen to the voice of the ancestors who speak to us sweetly, softly, ragefully, angrily, whatever they have to hear. Whatever they have to say, whatever we have to hear, rather, we open ourselves to it on this day. And we allow that higher principle, whatever the name is that we call that higher principle, whether we call it Christ, whether we call it God, whether we call it Jehovah, whether we call it Allah, whatever we call it, we allow that to refine whatever is said so that whatever we take with us is exactly what we need to go forth at this moment, on this day. We gather now. We prepare ourselves and we remain vigilant. I will now enter into a time of reflection through ritual. This is water from the Chickahominy River. Of course, we stand on what was originally and what really still is Powhatan land. We acknowledge that first. I have water from the James, and that will also stand in for this, for the honoring of the indigenous people. This water from the Chickahominy has a special resonance for me, however, because my family on my maternal grandmother's side is very much mixed in with Chickahominy people and related to the Chickahominy chief. And so I pour out this water in recognition of the indigenous people. This is water from the James, from the beaches of Jamestown. This represents the past of the ancestors, the past of the people of African descent. And of course, a beginning for the United States. A beginning. For many of the people of African descent here on these shores. This is the sand of the beaches of the James. And this represents the dust that forms our bodies from dust to dust. It also represents a past of the people of African descent on these shores. The blood that runs through our veins. Ether, the spirit that flows through each of us, connecting us, intertwining us, giving us life, regenerating us. Pure water, representing the present, representing the future, the eternal now. Thank you.
Listen. For the old ship of Zion. We'll hear the old ship of Zion now.
Is the
Yeah.
Really?
Spiritual says, I'm so glad my soul's got a hiding place. I am so glad my soul's got a hiding place. Listen more often to things than to beings. Listen more often to things than to beings. 'Tis the ancestor's breath when the fire's voice is heard. 'Tis the ancestor's breath in the voice of the waters. Those who have died have never left. The dead are not under the earth. They are in the rustling trees. They are in the groaning woods. They are in the crying grass. They are in the moaning rocks. The dead are not under the earth. We'll have some drums as I read out the names of some ancestors. Muhammad Ali, Richard Allen, Marian Anderson, Maya Angelou, Arthur Ashe, Crispus Attucks, Ella Baker, James Baldwin, Benjamin Banneker, Amiri Baraka, Mary McLeod Bethune, Steve Biko, Bessie Blount, Kobe Bryant, Mary Bowser, Gwendolyn Brooks, Rashard Brooks, Henry Box Brown, George Washington Carver, Bessie Coleman, Shirley Chisholm, John Henrik Clarke, John Coltrane, Alexander Crummell, Miles Davis, Ossie Davis and Ruby Dee, Martin R. Delaney, Frederick Douglass, W.E.B. Dubois, Paul Lawrence Dunbar, Catherine Dunham, Duke Ellington, Medgar Evers and Burley Evers Williams, Mary Fields, Aretha Franklin, George Floyd, George Floyd, George Floyd, say his name, George Floyd. Eric Garner, say his name, Eric Garner, Eric Garner. Marcus Garvey, Fannie Lou Hamer, Lorraine Hansberry, Dorothy Height, Oliver Hill, Charles Hamilton Houston, Jennifer Holliday, Langston Hughes, Jimi Hendrix, Francis Harper, Zora Neale Hurston, Nipsey Hussle, Imhotep, Michael Jackson, Katherine Johnson, Frederick Jones, Mae Jemison, Jack Johnson, Marsha P. Johnson, say her name, Marsha P. Johnson, Marsha P. Johnson, Malenga Karenga, Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., Henrietta Lacks, Joe Lewis, Mary Lumpkin, Mary Lumpkin, Patrice Lumumba, Nelson and Winnie Mandela, Thurgood Marshall, Trayvon Martin, say his name, Trayvon Martin, Trayvon Martin, Bob Marley, Benjamin E. Mays, Elijah McCoy, Claude McKay, Oscar Michaud, Hattie McDaniel, Cecil B. Moore, Garrett Morgan, Toni Morrison, Elijah Muhammad, Mansa Musa, Kwame Nkrumah, Queen Nzinga, Jesse Owens, Gordon Parks, Rosa Parks, Adam Clayton Powell Jr., Paul Robeson, Jackie Robinson, A. Philip Randolph, Lot Carey, Haile Selassie, Bayard Rustin, Nina Simone, Benjamin Pop Singleton, Breonna Taylor, Breonna Taylor, say her name, Breonna Taylor, say her name, Mary Church Terrell, Sojourner Truth, Harriet Tubman, Tupac, Kwame Ture, Harry McNeil Turner, Mary Turner, Nat Turner, David Walker, Madam C.J. Walker, Booker T. Washington, Ida B. Wells Barnett, Phyllis Wheatley, Roy Wilkins, Daniel Hale Williams, Gil Scott Heron, August Wilson, Carter G. Woodson, Richard Wright, Malcolm X, and Betty Shabazz, Shaka Zulu, Ahmaud Arbery, say his name, Ahmaud Arbery, say his name, Ahmaud Arbery. And so many more. And so many more. Listen, in relationship with the land, I ask you these questions. What do you sense? What do you feel? What do you perceive? What do you hear? What do you sense? What do you feel? What do you perceive? What do you hear? What do you sense? What do you feel? What do you perceive? What do you hear? You now have free rein to walk this land. You see the barriers. You may walk. You may sit, you may stand, you may take off your shoes if you feel so comfortable. But whatever you do, listen Listen and learn. You will be called back. And now you are free to walk. Thank you. podcasting. Return, return. Begin to take our seats or take our stand in position. We will begin our reflective period. And so I'll repeat the questions. What did you sense? Or what do you sense? What do you feel? What do you perceive? And what do you hear? If you would like, you can come up to the microphone to speak. I'll bring it out here. If there is anyone who would like to share.
Since I did not sit down yet, because it takes about a brain to get me up and down at this moment. Since we are all one, I don't know where I get the courage to say this all, because this is one of the reasons why we came as a family to Richmond. I was born in the Netherlands, so I am Dutch, so I know the huge role the Dutch play. The word apartheid is a Dutch word. It's even said with a Dutch intonation, apartheid. And if there's one thing that I do realize, is that there is only oneness. And so We lived in Canada for a while, so I got to experience there through people who reiterated these stories what was done to the Native American in Canada. Then we lived in California, forgive me, but we learned a lot about missions and the gold rush. We did not learn a lot about the Civil War. So we finally came through Pittsburgh to Richmond. And I knew that there was something that got me here because my parents had a cigarette and tobacco store in the Netherlands. So tobacco is, you know, like where when my mother came over here and I showed her the plantations and I showed her around, my mother literally came full circle. Because she had sold tobacco, but she had never seen except on blue and white tiles from the Delft factory what the custom was and how to sell and how to weigh and who worked on the fields. So my mother went to, and she experienced the Second World War, so I mean, as an elementary school person. So, I mean, everybody has their pain, everybody has their sorrow, but we are all one. So my mother went to the Jefferson Plantation, and after a while, when we walked around, my mother said, "So was Jefferson a good slave owner?" I said, "Why don't you ask the guy? Because I do not know how to answer that." And so the guy said, "Well, just consider the word slave owner. I mean, we don't have the same word on that." So we all feel part of this. We all feel part of this celebration. So today, I picked up my Black United We Stand t-shirt and I was like, black pants, black shirt. Nope, I don't feel like that. It's gotta be a celebration of the new. We are so sorry and so hurt by all that happened, but we have a chance to move on and embrace and ask for forgiveness, whoever it is, for anything that was experienced. And we can make a difference. And thank you for listening. This is my path, and this is the part. I literally, as a 4, 5, 6-year-old, picked up the packages of cigarettes in my parents' store, and I would think, it was the one package where I would stand still and go, "I wonder where Chesterfield is." So I know that there is a reason why I came all this way and see the fields. And we came to, not Jamestown, but the city of Henricus, and all four of my blonde kids planted the stalks and put the beans in and put the fish stuff around it to start the city of Henricus. So it's like we all try to be part of that history to make it move forward. And if there's anything I can do, that is what I would like to celebrate today. We're here to move forward and to celebrate the new. Thank you.
Of it all, I came up with a poem, and it said, "Ancestors cry from the grave. Hear my spirit, my sons and daughters, as we cry from the grave, from the essence of your very soul. Be glad that you didn't live when I lived, but know that you have opportunities to bring about social changes for my bloodline. Made in his image. You are a moving force. You can break down barriers and you can kick down walls and you can flow on the rivers of life. can soar like an eagle. In the midst of the storm is your greatest strength, your strength to soar, to be victimized, but yet not a victim, because you have the inner strength of your ancestors. Hear me as I cry. Know that I am your biggest fan through the spirit of the ancestors. Hear me, hear me, hear me when I cry. When you are being mistreated, being strung out on doubt and fears, and embarked on trials and tribulation, hear me when your blood and tears are mixed with the filtration of accomplishments and failures. I am crying from the grave to tell you to get to know the greatest I am, but the bloodline was mixed in with mine to be able to live victorious in spite of, because there is a better beyond for where I live and cry from the grave. Hear my spirit, said the ancestor.
We have time for just one more short, if you have a short reflection. We'd like to, sure, Miss Annette.
Short and sweet. Pain and hope.
To Miss Valerie.
Thank you so much, Jabril. Wasn't that beautiful? Give him a round of applause. That is awesome. I am so proud of him. Thank you. So, I forgot to mention earlier, I do have some water here, so if anyone's thirsty, please come help yourself. I think many people brought their own, so good for you. That was great. I'm going to give a short reflection, just a short reflection. I was telling Jabril earlier that last night I couldn't sleep. I was very restless. And as I walked around the grounds today, that was still the sense that I was feeling, very restless. And I feel like I'm sensing that restlessness from the ancestors. And I think the reason that I'm feeling that restlessness from our ancestors is because here it is, the year 2020, and they have fought, and they have sacrificed, and they have died so that a future generation who they would never know would have the freedoms and benefits of life that they could not enjoy. But here we are in 2020, almost reliving an experience that they would never have imagined we would be living right now. So I think it is incumbent on each and every one of us here to stand into our power and to stand into the vision that the ancestors held for us and make a difference. We, each and every one of us, can do something to make a difference. We can do something to make positive change. So next we're going to listen to a song, and it's a song from the soundtrack of the Harriet movie. But before I do that, I want to share a short story with you. Last year, I attended a session called Family Constellations, and I'm sure a few of you are familiar with that, but it's a session where folks are in a room. And it's facilitated by someone who then does this practice that calls family relations. And it's a process that is bent on healing family relations. But in the midst of going through this practice of family constellations, you get to tap into the spirit of your ancestors. And I had the privilege of having that experience last year. And I will say that that was one of the most profound experiences of my life. Very, very moving. And what happened was, at toward the end of the program, I'm standing, and all the people in the room are standing around me, and they're all talking to me, speaking to me as if they are my ancestors. And what I discovered was that I had then, as I have right in this very moment, just a league of ancestors standing behind me, supporting me in everything I do. I had the people speak to me, and one thing that they said that I will never, ever, ever forget is they're speaking to me as the ancestors would be speaking to me. They said, "You honor us by being free. You honor us by being free." They fought, they sacrificed, they died for a vision of freedom for generations they would not know. So as you listen to the lyrics in this song, think about what freedom is to you, how you can honor those who came before, and what you can do to answer freedom's call. So I'm going to ask you to stand up as we listen to this song. Thank you.
Face turned to the sun. Weight on my shoulders, a bullet in my gun.
What happened?
Until I die, so I'm gone.
Requesting that you find space where you are, and what I want you to do, I'm going to tell you about my experience, and I also want you to have the experience that I had walking. I got a wind hug, and in that hug was love, in that hug was peace, in that hug was joy, in that hug was time to celebrate. Celebrate. We've talked about the history. We've gone back with this beautiful poem. Thank you, my sister. And I want to thank Jabril for educating us. And I want to thank Valerie also for bringing this to us. But it's time for us to celebrate. You know the history. It's in your bones. So what I want you to do is step with your feet apart like this. Turn around three times, slowly. And as you turn, what you're going to be experiencing is the wind. And let the wind kiss your face. Let the wind kiss your chest. Let the wind kiss your waist. Let the wind kiss all parts of you from the top of your head to the tip of your toe. Because you're going to be spinning in love. Love above you, love below you because of what's under this ground. And love all around. So here we go. That's one. Now, wherever you are, just hug yourself. Hug yourself. Hold yourself. You are beautiful, you are bold, you are bodacious. Made in love, by love, for love. You are here to be what God intended for you to be. Now that you've got all this, you have to remember, hug yourself some more. Hug yourself, love yourself. They paid a price for you to love yourself. Allow the elements to embrace you. I believe in all of nature. All of nature comes to give us this big hug. Hug yourself. Now kind of move with it. Move with it. Move with it.
created heaven and the earth. And although we have people that are buried in the earth, there's love and joy that comes from the earth as well. So you got a wind hug today. And the next time that you step out, I get on a motorcycle. I've been on a motorcycle and got a wind hug when I needed to. I used to have a convertible to get some wind hugs. Allow nature to embrace you. Allow nature to penetrate you. Allow nature to saturate you with the love of the divine. Because as I said before, you're made in love, by love, for love, to be loved. And the other thing that I want you to remember today, everybody has talked about breath. Breath. Breath is life. Breath is life. And breath is what connects everybody in here. Because the same creator that gave me breath, that when it created all humankind, and I call God the BG, the God and Goddess of the universe, to me is the Big G. It breathed into us and we became living souls. And the souls that we became, you have to listen. Like today, you have to listen to it to see what it's telling you what you need to do. All this information will serve to nothing if you don't go out and empower yourself to make a difference in your community. At first, it has to start in your home. Can I get an amen? Amen. It has to start in your home, educating your children. And I have to tell you, all the systems that are in place, government, state, worldwide, education, medical, they're here to keep you in a maze. You are in, actually, a matrix. You're in a matrix. And all these distractions with consumerism and all of that stuff that comes to take us away from our true self. Recognize it. Recognize you being tricked. Recognize that you can claim who you are. But the way to get to that, you have to sit down and reflect and listen to the Big G, or whatever you call it. Higher power source. It don't care what you call it, as long as you acknowledge it. And everything flows from it to you when you listen. Sometimes it's a little still, small voice. And sometimes you have to be hit with a cosmic 2x4. And when you're hit, it'll smack you, but it'll be gentle. And you don't have to become a victim of anything that comes to you in your life. All you have to do is claim your power. You have it inside of you. You are beautiful. You are bold. You are bodacious. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
I was raised by a Baptist preacher. That's why I come with that, right? I was raised by a Baptist preacher. But the other thing that I want you to remember, and I want you to repeat this after me. It's a good day.
It's a good day.
I can't hear you.
It's a good day.
It's a good day to be alive.
It's a good day.
It's a good day to be alive.
I'm talking.
And you are walking.
Yeah,
and you are moving. And most of all, you are breathing. Because it could have been the other way, as my mother would say. You are in the land of the living. So appreciate breath. Y'all know what happened around breath. I don't need to repeat it. All we need to do is learn to coexist. Coexist. Coexist with the birds, the bees, everything in the trees. Coexist with your neighbor. Coexist whether they're black, white, red, or brown. We need to learn how to coexist. And when we can coexist, we'll have peace and harmony through all humanity. And then, what I want you to remember, that you are made by the Creator that created the stars, that created all the planets, that created everything in the universe. You were created by a master artist. The master artist created you. And therefore, you are a masterpiece. Say, I'm a masterpiece.
I am a masterpiece.
I want to see energy. Bring it from with above you, bring it from below you. I'm a masterpiece.
Masterpiece.
I am a masterpiece.
Masterpiece.
I shine. I shimmer. sugar. I sparkle. And as Reverend Laura would say, I sizzle. I sizzle. And what you sizzle with is zest, zest, and zeal, and vim, and vigor. You need to remember that. It's in you. Y'all, sometimes we forget. We have forgotten. I know I forget. I don't remember every day, but I'm here to remind you that you are a masterpiece. That you are an SSS human being. Say, I shimmer. I shine. I shine. I am a spiritual being. I'm a soulful being. Today, what I want you to remember, those three things, that you have breath, that nature is here to support you, that right here where we stand is holy. And we're on a mission. We all been charged today to go out. We're on a mission to help make this transition, Jabril. We're on a mission. And what you have to do is to set your intention every day and let, because a holy shift is on the way. It's already happening. A holy shift. Can I get an amen? And the other part that I want you to remember with those essence, because you're made of a star, the same thing that made the star, the same thing that made the moon, the same thing that made each little blade of grass that's on this ground, the same thing that made all those trees. And trees are your friend. Trees are your friend. I walk in nature and I sit for 3 and 4 hours just about every day. And they will talk to you and give you their secrets if you just sit and listen. That's what you can use as a tool during all of these times of uncertainty. Remember that. But the same energy that created black, white, brown, or blue, it did not know any color. It decided, well, I created all these other things, I'm gonna create something even above that. It created you. And it said, that's good. It said, that's good. So remember, today, let's take a breath. Breathe out. That it's a good day to be alive. And that breath is life. And life is meant to be lived in full expression. And that you are a masterpiece. And most of all, you are a star. And what I want you to do is come and phone a soul train line. It's social distancing. Starting from right here. Form a soul train line. Soul train. Soul train line. Social distancing. You can make
soul train.
We got to go.
Just Mercy. So I would love to have you participate in that. After the film, we're going to see a brief interview with Brian Stevenson, the author of the book, and just have a brief discussion. So it is free. The movie is free for the month of June. And if you go to the link, you will see any number of about 20 ways that you can hook up and get that movie, okay? When we met last February, we decided that our volunteer event was going to be to clean up the Evergreen Cemetery. That's the cemetery where Maggie L. Walker's body is interred. And we had a group of people that had signed up to say they wanted to do it before the pandemic hit. I have talked to Evergreen Cemetery, and we are on their books for July the 25th from 9 to 1, excuse me, 9 to 12. So part of being a part of We Stand Undivided means that you are out doing something of some benefit to someone in the community. So what I want you to do is to take your phones. You don't have to do it at this moment, but go to westandundivided.com/Juneteenth, please. And if you go there, you'll see a brief survey. What we do is we capture what people are doing so we can know how change is happening here in our communities. So if you go to www.westandundivided.com/Juneteenth, you can put your email address in there and we can contact you about upcoming events. You can sign up to be part of the volunteer effort at Evergreen Cemetery, and you can also let us know what you are committing to doing as a part of being here today. So no one leaves here without a commitment of some kind. And we have on this table these white cards. They're called commitment cards, and you can take one of those with you. And that is just for you to keep, to say that this is what you're doing to commit to serving the cause of humanity. Okay, great. So I'm going to give it to Jabril, who is going to close us out. Thank you so much for being here.
So I think of today, and I think that we have tarried. I don't know if anybody knows of that from the Black religious tradition, the tarry service, where you would wait and wait on the spirit to move. And so sometimes in Black worship experiences, it can be a little bit long. It can be a little long because you're lingering, you're waiting on the spirit to move. We have definitely done that today. I thank you all for being here, and I send from my heart to yours peace, peace, go in peace always. Thank you. Good night.